I'm going to show you how you can stream your Steam games from your PC to your Raspberry Pi in RetroPie 4.2. And it's going to be the simplest method out there by none. I'm talking this method is not out there on the internet right now, so stick around because you know what time it is. Hey guys, Jonathan here with TechWizTime, where I teach you technology through tutorials. And today I'm going to teach you how to install Steam streaming on your RetroPie 4.2 installation with minimal effort. And when I say minimal, I mean minimal. So there are quite a lot of videos out there that do the Steam streaming with the Raspberry Pis, and you can find them all through YouTube. I've even done two myself. But the difference here is that what I've done is I've combined every method out there possible and put it into one script. So all you need to do is run that and it'll guide you through the rest. So I can guarantee this has not been done in any other video. So before you click off, make sure you stick around because I'm going to show you how easy it is and how you can download it yourself. Now, a couple of little disclaimers. You do need a GeForce capable graphics card in your PC with the Steam installation on it. It needs to be a GTX 650 plus or greater. You need to have GeForce Experience installed and it needs to be the latest version so you can enable the Gamestream option. And I highly recommend that you hook up your Raspberry Pi to a wired network on the same network as your Steam machine. This has got to do with latency and also drops in frames per second and all that sort of thing. So if you want the best experience, I highly recommend Ethernet or a wired connection. So before we go any further, make sure you like this video and share it with your friends because sharing is caring. So with that little bit of a ramble out of the way, what I'll do is I'll show you over on the PC now what you need to enable in Gamestream so that way you can start doing this on your Raspberry Pi. And with that said, let's jump over to the computer. Okay, so to open up GeForce Experience, just hit the start button and start typing in GeForce and it should come up as a menu item there. Once you've got it open, you need to go up to the little cogwheel that when you hover over it, it says settings. Then inside settings, down the right hand side, it should say Gamestream ready. If it does say that there, then you're ready to go. All you need to do is go down to Shield on the left-hand side, and beside the word Gamestream, move that little slider switch until it turns green. Once you've done that, Gamestream is now enabled. Okay, so now that you've got Gamestream all set up and it's all ready to go, we'll pop over to the Raspberry Pi now, and what we'll do is I'll show you how to download and install the script and run it. So once you've got RetroPie loaded up, what you need to do is you need to either press F4 on the keyboard or go to the Start menu and go down to Quit Emulation Station. Once you're at the command prompt, you need to type this in on the screen now. I've also put it down in the link down in the description below because it is quite a long string. But what this is doing is basically getting the script that I created off of GitHub. So the next thing we need to do is we need to make this script file executable. And to do that, we type in sudo chmod plus x moonlight.sh and press enter. And now that it's executable, we want to run this as a super user. So what we do is we type in sudo /moonlight.sh and this will start the script off. So here we can press any key, but make sure you check off and make sure each of those things on the list is done so that way we can continue. So I've split this into phases. So if there is an issue that you can tell me what phase it actually stopped working at, so that way I can help troubleshoot it and get you a fix. So phase one is adding Moonlight to the sources list. Then phase two is fetching and installing some GPG keys. This is just so you know that it's the real thing. Phase three is where it does a little bit of an update. This bit might take a while, so just be prepared. It probably will only take about a minute or two, so just be patient. Phase four is installing the actual Moonlight software onto your Raspberry Pi. Now, phase five, this is where you map the controller. So what I've done here is I've put a little stop, so that way you just press any key once you're ready. Just make sure your controller is plugged in, and when it is, then you press any key to continue. Go through and press the corresponding keys, and once you're done, it will tell you that it's successful. Now, phase six is where you need to input your IP address for the machine that you'll be connecting to, so the machine that has Steam. I'll show you really quickly here now how to do that. On a Windows 10 machine, all you need to do is press the start button and start typing in network and select network and sharing center. Under connections will be the blue link, click on that, and then click the details button. This will give your machine's current IP address, and that should be the IPv4 address. So now that we've got that back on the Raspberry Pi, we'll type that address in and then press enter. This will give us a PIN number. And if everything is connected and your Steam machine is on the right network, it should pop up requesting a PIN on your PC. So type this in and press okay. Once this is done, it will say that it's successfully paired and move on to the next phases. Here it will move fairly quickly, but phase 7 is creating the launch scripts inside RetroPie. Phase 8 creates the Steam menu item inside RetroPie. Phase 9 is just making sure everything has the correct ownership and so forth. And then once it's all complete, it will ask you if you want to reboot or not. Just hit yes here and the system will reboot. After a little bit, it will finish rebooting and it will come back to the RetroPie main screen. And here you will see a Steam menu item. So go into there and you'll see 4 menu items. 2 of them are for 1080p and 2 of them are for 720p at either 30 frames per second or 60 frames per second. For some people, 1080p at 60 frames per second doesn't work that well, so that's why I've included the other options here in case your network isn't up to scratch. Select one here and I'll just quickly show you Fallout 4 running through my Raspberry Pi through streaming with this really quick, simple setup. War. War never changes. But the Raspberry Pi setup scripts do. How awesome is that? So now you've got Steam streaming through your Raspberry Pi 3 using RetroPie 4.2. Awesome! Now, can you think of anything else that you want to streamline on your RetroPie installation or maybe even Kodi? Then leave me a comment down below and let me know, because I'm going to be writing new scripts all the time and I want to make this as simple for everyone as possible. Don't forget, if you learned something here today or if you're using this script, to like this video and also share it with your friends on Reddit and Facebook, because really, sharing is caring. And it really helps promote my channel and get it out there to a lot more people, because all I want to do is teach people what I know. Make sure you subscribe to this channel, and if you are already, then make sure you hit that bell icon too so you get notified of when I release new videos. And as always, imagine, learn, create.